So cubital tunnel syndrome or ulnar nerve entrapment, it's one of the commonest peripheral nerve compression. The most common one is carpal tunnel syndrome, and the second most common is compression of the ulnar nerve, which is cubital tunnel syndrome. So as the nerve travels around the elbow, along the forearm into the little and ring finger, it also gives a small branch on the dorsal aspect of the hand. So patients with compression of the ulnar nerve will have a little numbness on the dorsal aspect of the hand, pins and needles and tingling sensation in the little and ring finger, which is dynamic. So on examination, if we bend the elbow and keep it bent for a while, patients start experiencing aches, pains, and a tingling sensation in the little and ring finger. In extending elbow, the symptoms will ease off. In advanced cases, we can see muscle wasting, which is the muscle wasting in the first web space and also in the interossei muscles. So you can see that the bones become more prominent than they are now. There also may be muscle wasting in the hypotenar area. In really severe cases, you may see clawing of the little and ring fingers. In early stages, we advise patients to keep the elbow rather straight and try not to lean on the elbow. It's quite common to have positional cubital tunnel syndrome, where either long distance drivers or patients with habits of bending the elbow and leaning on it compress the ulnar nerve and cause the symptoms. Once you extend the elbow, the symptoms may disappear. So it's usually adaptation of the daily living and really explaining what's going on so then patient can change their habits. Ulnar nerve compression is usually not a serious condition if recognized and treated properly or early. Patient may end up with weakness, muscle wasting, and a permanent numbness in the little and ring finger. Once the muscle wasting happens, it's unfortunately irreversible. It means that even after successful decompression and release of the ulnar nerve, the muscle wasting still stays there. The strength of the hand may improve for over 2 years or so, but it's never the same as it was before. Conservative treatment with changing activities of the daily living, or perhaps even wearing some kind of splint or brace to keep the elbow extended during the night, may take a few months for the symptoms to settle. If the symptoms don't settle or they are severe, we'll perform surgery. Surgery, cubital tunnel release, is done usually either peripheral nerve block, could be a general anesthetic. There is a small cut on the median aspect of the elbow, about 10-12 centimeters there, and through the small incision, I release the ulnar nerve from the more proximal to the distal part. There are a few places where the nerve could be potentially trapped, so I release all the potential compression sites. After the surgery, patient has a bulky dressing and start gently mobilizing elbow within the bandage. And then once we take the stitches out, patient is able to fully mobilize.